everybody. My name is Zach Wall, back for another TechLink Expert Series video demonstrating the process in preparing a model for ALM. So last video we provided some initial knowledge transfer, and now we will be demoing each step in an actual model example. A quick review of the steps. First, we're going to take the current production model offline just to lock out any end users that might be in the model. Then we will be marking production lists, production imports, and import data sources. In the next step, we will be making a copy of the production model, immediately deploying that production model, and then mapping model-to-model imports if necessary. So really quickly, if you need more background information, please refer to the first video. All right, so here we have our sample production model. So right now we know this model is in standard mode, and it's also online. Before we start doing any sort of prep work, we're going to want to lock out any end users from the model. So what we're going to want to do is take this model offline. We're going to go into model management. Our model is selected here. We're going to take it offline. Select OK. Model is now offline, as it shows right here. Next, we want to mark production lists and import data sources. We're going to go over to lists. As we can see, we have one checked already. Typically, it's the last child of a hierarchy. This is a hierarchy right here that is a production list. However, it should be noted that if you do a parent of the hierarchy, it's going to roll all the way up as such. Another sample I have preset here is type of restaurant. Let's see what happens when we try and promote this to production data. Okay, so we get an error. So let's take a look at what that looks like really quickly. As we can see right here, it's the same example that we had in the slide deck earlier. Here I have an if statement that references the specific list item of company owned as it pertains to the type of restaurant. So we would have to change this formula. There is a workaround reference on the Anaplan community if you're interested in doing so. Okay, back to lists. So just double checking, I have my level 3 restaurants checked as production data. That's all set. So now what I'm going to do is check my imports and import data sources. Here we can mark whatever imports that we'd like. I'm just going to mark the first three. And then because we did these imports, we're going to go ahead and do those same data sources as well. And as stated, this is going to allow end users in a deployed mode model to upload their own files as necessary, as well as edit the mappings of their imports. So now we're going to want to make a copy of this model. We're going to say this is our production model because we have all integrations set up for this model itself. Go to copy. And typically what we like to do is have the same base name of the model and then tag on the instance, whether dev, test, or production, to the end of the name itself. Save. And here we have our dev instance opened up automatically. So what we have now is two exact copies of the model. And in the eyes of Anaplan, these are two compatible models. And to preserve this compatibility, we're going to want to freeze any changes to the structural data in the production model. And of course, to do that, we have to change the mode of our production model to deployed mode. As you can see, because you made a copy of that model, the dev instance is automatically offline, just as a side note. Here's our production model. It's also offline. We're going to change the mode to deployed mode. So navigating back to our model in deployed mode, as you can see, all these icons here show that the model is deployed itself. So we're going to open our production model.
And as we see in the production model, we have both the model status and the model mode at the top, indicating some of the axis of this model. Now what we're going to do is try and make a quick change. Let's see if we're able to remove a button. As you can see, we get an error here. We're trying to change some structural data in the model, and it's not going to let us do it. It is interesting to note, though, that you are able to make changes, but you're not able to save changes. And that just means the changes that you're making are for your eyes only. Nobody else can see the changes that you made because they're not saved. And with this instance, we don't have to go and remap any of these source models. Anyways, that's all I have for you guys on prepping models for ALM. For more information on the next steps in the ALM process regarding the compare and sync process, stay tuned for our next video.